I was a real surprise, particularly because the record's not really a traditional sort of pop record. It's more of a classical thing, so it's not the kind of thing that's going to get played on Triple J, at least not unless it's 2 a.m. Yeah, a real honour to have that kind of music sit alongside a lot of the indie pop stuff. Everyone votes for things they've already heard about, and if you're already on the train, then of course you get more publicity. Otherwise, smaller artists that don't have the same resources or don't make music that's that popular don't get the same exposure. So I think it's really good to have a meritocratic award. Of course, I sent the record in months ago. I could completely. Whenever you do those things, it's nice to just forget about having sent it, and just if something happens, something happens. You know, it's that classic thing where you see a blocked call or a number that you don't know, and you think it's going to be like a real estate agent or something. But it was really lovely to hear from him, and quite a surprise. It's really nice to have a prize where the judges actually take the time to listen to a record from start to finish and assess it after that, rather than looking to see if it's something they've already heard of or not. There was a great record this guy Mark Dawson made under the name Brambles, and that's a really beautiful solo piano record. Again, that's kind of sort of classical music, but that has an indie sort of sensibility. And there's so much great electronic music that's come out of Melbourne the last year or so. I'm fortunate to have this amazing 16-year-old cousin who's always throwing me stuff, and his music, which is under the name Japanese Wallpaper, is great. And also people like Kyson and Thruppence and all this music I've been introduced to. It's a lot of it coming out of Melbourne, which is really, really exciting. Hi, I'm Luke Howard, and my record Suncloud was longlisted for this year's Australian Music Prize.